The first prototype, it was so bad that the drill crashed. It was a big mess. It showed how challenging a 7xD can be.
The development started up somewhere in 2012. One huge obstacle we ran into developing the DS20 was to obtain the perfect cutting force balance. We can have no room for errors. Perfection was needed.
When you go from the 5xD as the standard today to 7xD, the bending of the tool increases by x3, so this was a big challenge.
Before, with 5xD, maybe you talk about millimeters, but now we talk about microns. How do you get microns under control? We have about 50 different parameters, and these parameters interact with each other.
It's like changing the sound on a mixer table. You have 50 variables, and if you change one, you have to change all the other 49 to find the sweet spot where the music or the tool works as it's intended.
We had failed many times. It's a loop that goes round and round and round. With every loop, you learn something. And that's how you contribute to knowledge. It's making progress even though you fail. So at one point, you see that, wait a minute, but right now it's getting a lot better. There's something here, we have to move faster now.
We finally solved it by developing and fine-tuning a new software for calculating cutting force balance.
We could simulate and tie together all the parameters. It's a real breakthrough moment, that one.
Making the cutting force to one tool is easy, but making it to work in all drills is almost impossible unless you have that software. We knew about a facility in Mexico that would fit all the needs to do really good pilot tests. The customer was very nervous. He was not at all confident in either us or the tool. The result was about almost a 100% increase of productivity and a 100% increase of tool life. To be the first company in the world to put a 7x diameter indexable insert drill to the market feels very good. If anyone else tries to do it, they will get to know how difficult it is.